church or worshipping online, a very warm welcome to evening prayer. The 25th of April is kept as the feast of St. Mark the Evangelist, although because it's a Sunday in Eastertide, Mark is being transferred to tomorrow. So tonight is the first evening prayer of St. Mark. John Mark was a Jew, and according to Paul's letter to the Colossians, a cousin to St. Barnabas. He accompanied Barnabas and Paul on their first missionary journey, and afterwards went to Cyprus, then to Rome, first of all with Paul and then Peter. The gospel which bears his name is generally regarded as the earliest of the four, and was most likely written whilst he was in Rome, and is probably based as much on Peter's preaching of the good news as on Mark's own memory. The gospel has a sharpness and an immediacy about it, and it has not spared the apostles in noting their various weaknesses and their lack of understanding as Jesus as the Christ, the Messiah, who would suffer for the world. Sharing in the glory of the resurrection means sharing in the giving of self, both in body and spirit, even to death. Sharing the gospel was, for all, in essence, both excessively generous and ultimately sacrificial. O Lord, open thou our hearts,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament showeth his handiwork.
One day telleth another, and one night certifieth another.
There is neither speech nor language, but their voices are heard among them.
Their sound is gone out into all lands, and their words into the ends of the world.
In them hath he set a tabernacle for the sun, which cometh forth as a bridegroom out of his chamber, and rejoiceth as a giant to run his course.
It goeth forth from the uttermost part of the heaven, and runneth about unto the end of it again, and there is nothing hid from the heat thereof.
The law of the Lord is an undefiled law, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, and giveth wisdom unto the simple.
The statutes of the Lord are right, and rejoice the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, and giveth light unto the eyes.
The fear of the Lord is clean, and endureth forever. The judgments of the Lord are true, and righteous altogether.
More to be desired are they than gold, yea, than much fine gold. Sweeter also than honey and the honeycomb.
Moreover, by them is thy servant taught, and in keeping of them there is great reward.
Who can tell how oft he offendeth? O cleanse thou me from my secret faults.
Keep thy servant also from presumptuous sins, lest they get the dominion over me. So shall I be undefiled, and innocent from the great offence.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be always acceptable in thy sight.
O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
It was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,
world without end.
Amen. First lesson from the prophecy of Isaiah, chapter 52, beginning at the 7th verse. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace, who brings good news, who announces salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your sentinels lift up their voices, together they sing for joy. For in plain sight they see the return of the Lord to Zion. Break forth together into singing, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has comforted his people, he has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm before the eyes of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God. Here endeth the first lesson. My soul doth magnify the Lord, And my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Saviour.
For he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaid.
For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed.
For he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name.
And his mercy is on them that fear him throughout all generations.
He hath showed strength in his arm, he hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts.
He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek.
He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away.
He, remembering his mercy, hath holpen his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and his seed forever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
It was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Second lesson from the Gospel according to St. Mark in the first chapter, beginning at the first verse. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord. Make his paths straight.'" John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt round his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee, and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart, and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness for 40 days, tempted by Satan, and he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaimed the good news of God, saying, "The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." Here endeth the second lesson. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word.
For mine eyes have seen thy salvation,
which thou hast prepared before the face of all people,
to be a light to light of the Gentiles, and to the glory of thy people Israel.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen,
and mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only O God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us,
and take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
Almighty God, who enlightened your holy church through the inspired witness of your evangelist, St. Mark, grant that we, being firmly grounded in the truth of the gospel, may be faithful to its teaching, both in word and deed. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Almighty God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Saviour.
Amen.
Light in our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And so, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we pray for your church. Quicken your people with the new life of your Son's resurrection, that in every place those who are his may be the leaven of sincerity and truth at work in your world. We give thanks for the life, witness and writings of St. Mark, and pray for all Christian communities dedicated to him. We ask you to bless the household of faith in this Diocese of Southwark, for Christopher, our Bishop, and for all who live and work here. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all who exercise power and authority in human affairs. Enlighten with your holy wisdom all those whose decisions affect the lives of others, all who influence and shape the opinions of others, whether through journalism, broadcasting or education. May they seek to serve the truth with humility and for the common good. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear.
Loving Father, we pray to you for the sick and for all who are afflicted or in distress, for all victims of warfare, the dispossessed and the displaced. Comfort and strengthen them and all who try to help them, and give your healing and salvation to all in their affliction and pain, in particular those who are known to us and who have asked for our own personal prayers. Lord, in thy mercy, and receive to yourself all who have died. Raise them up from the gates of death, and establish with them your covenant of life beyond the grave, giving thanks for all who have walked with us the way of faith. For those who will die this night, and praying for all who mourn. thy mercy. Heavenly Father, your mercy is over all that you have made. Assist your people in this and every land. Govern them in peace and justice. Defend them from the enemies of life. And bring us all into the fellowship of Blessed Mary, St. Mark, and all the redeemed, to that new creation of your love and mercy, where you live and reign in glory, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.